Amen. We have Minister Devin. Amen. Coming. Amen. The final word of the night. Amen. 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 So we ask that you can just give God some praise as he comes and he shares.
And again he entered Capernaum after some days, and it was heard that he was in the house. Immediately many gathered together so that there was no longer room to receive them, not even near the door. And he preached the word to them. Then they came to him bringing a paralytic who was carried by four men. And when they could not come near him because of the crowd, they uncovered the roof where he was. So when they had broken through, they let down the bed on which the paralytic was lying. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven you." And some of the scribes were sitting there and reasoning in their hearts, "Why does this man speak blasphemies like this? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" But immediately when Jesus perceived in the spirit that they reasoned thus within themselves, he said to them, Why do you reason about these things in your hearts? Which is easier to say to the paralytic, "Your sins are forgiven you," or to say, "Arise, take up your bed and walk"? But that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins, he said to the paralytic, "I say to you, arise, take up your bed, and go to your house." My topic is identity, the antidote for spiritual paralysis. So, you know, that's why I like what Deion said, to see, you know, he's talking about we have to trust God. And one of the key components of trusting God is knowing who you are in God. Knowing that first you are a child, when you are adopted in this kingdom, the Holy Spirit is put in you, you are a child. And for this man, the root of his paralysis was an identity issue. And the Lord showed him that because the first thing that came out of Jesus' mouth was "Son." He said, "Son, your sins are forgiven you." And you know, some of us, you know, some of us in here, you know, it was me myself. We were paralyzed because we had an identity issue. We didn't know who we were, you know, fully in God. We like this guy, he was alive, but he wasn't walking. You know what I mean? So some of us are alive, but we're not walking the things of God. It's because, you know, we don't know who we are in God. We don't know that we are, God's, you know, children. The next point I have is, you know, people can carry us, but they can only carry us for so long. And where they carry us, they should be carrying us to Jesus, not carrying us anywhere else. It's to, you know, the bar, carrying us this way, or, sometimes people might try to carry other people to themselves, to keep them to themselves. But our job is when we see people who are struggling, we carry them to Jesus because he's the only one who can you can make that person whole. Like I said before, the man, he was alive, he was walking, you know, because he wasn't confident in who he was, you know, and fully he wasn't confident in who he was in God. And that spoke to me because for me, I grew up in the church and, you know, this and that, and, you know, I was told to be a worship leader, so I was playing the piano, and I knew that I was a servant of God, but I did not know that I was a child of God. I mean, I read about it, but it didn't hit me until God spoke to me and said, "I call you son." And that completely changed my life because, there's a short little story. When my younger brother, Rocky, was really little, he had super long dreadlocks, and he was in first grade, and he had to go to the bathroom, so he went to the boys' bathroom. There were some other boys who started picking on him. They said, "No, you're a girl, you can't go to the bathroom." He's like, "I'm a boy." He's like, "No, you can't go to the bathroom." So he ended up peeing his pants. So he ran home and told my dad. My dad got up, went to the school, was talking to the principal, he was chew out the parents, chew out the kid. And, you know, that brought to my attention because sometimes the devil may bully us, but all we have to do is, you know what, devil? You can bully me, but you got to answer to my dad. You know, you feel bullied by different types of things. You know, you got to be like my younger brother, where you go into the house, which is, you can go into God's presence, you take off your backpack, which is taking off the things of the world, and you say, God, I'm being attacked. What can I do, or what can you do? And like David said, you know, the scripture where he said, you know, smoke came out of his nostrils and he descended on black clouds of smoke. That's the same God who did that for David is the same God who will do that for us. So no matter what we're going through or what we might be facing, what the devil may throw away, sometimes we don't even have to fight. You know what I mean? Like the Bible says, be still and know that I am God. And the Bible also says, you know, stand still and see the salvation, you know, of the Lord. And God will, you know, sometimes he might have us fight, but you gotta wait on his word. You know what I mean? Don't just start swinging at the devil if you don't have the authority of God, because that can be a mess. You know what I mean? Wait for God to say, now do this, and then you do it. And when you have him back up, you got all angels back up on your hand. And if we don't realize who we are in God, we can be stuck in fear. And I believe, you know, we're still at the Jordan River that we need to cross. And if we don't know who we are in God, and you know, sometimes some of us don't know who we are in God, we're his child, so we're scared to cross into our destiny. You know what I mean? Because we don't know what's going to happen. But once we know who we are in God, you know, Dad, you got the choice. You can take care of this. You can take care of whatever may come, you know, my way in the future. So, finally, there are people waiting on us to realize who we are in God. The scripture says, that the earth is groaning for the sons of God to be revealed, for us to finally realize, you know, who we are, who is God, who God intended us to be a child, his child first, and then to do what he called, you know, us to do. Sometimes we can say that, we can attach ourselves to our gifts and say that that's our identity. But first you're a child, and then you do the things that, you know, then you do the things that God created. That means you can be gifted, but then, you know, you have to fail. Scripture says, the Lord didn't I do this, I didn't have to offer something, but, you know, he said, depart from me, I never knew you. But, you know, if you're a child of God, you have relationship with him, and then, you know, you can cry out,
Amen. 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 Awesome word. Amen. Amen. Amen.